This is FCBCtv News, your weekly news source.
Good morning, Faithful Central. I know the big game was a couple of Sundays ago, but today is California State University's Super Sunday. I'm Kente Scott.
And I'm Kimberly Dooley. Information on how you can prepare for admissions and financial aid will be available immediately following service. And welcome to all our visitors, including Vice President of California State Long Beach, Dr. Douglas Robinson. Welcome.
Are you a young man between the ages of 11 and 14? What are your plans for the future? Did every 11 and 14-year-old in the congregation just go like this? Forget about it. Just go check out our rites of passage. Recruitment is going on now for young men to participate in this year-long mentoring program. We are also looking for men who want to serve as mentors. Help these young men learn from your testimonies. Sign up at the Rites of Passage table outside for the 2012 class or to be a mentor.
Come with Bishop Omer as he celebrates one of his spiritual son's accomplishments. Greater Zion celebrates Pastor Michael Fisher's anniversary. If you have never seen Bishop minister in someone else's house, don't miss this time of fellowship today at 5 p.m.
Every week we do a job check to show, even in this time, God is still faithful. And Faithful Central is faithful, too. So take a moment. If you found a job this week, stand up and give yourself a round of applause. Clap your hands and stomp your feet if you found a job with benefits. FCBC is recruiting for a database coordinator and a discipleship groups coordinator. So hand in your resumes by the Tuesday, February 21st deadline. Make sure to visit www.faithfulcentral.com and click FCBC Open Positions.
As Black History Month rolls on, here's this week's BLAQmatics.
That's BLAQmatics, not Black Magic. Some folks get confused on that. Hey there, and I'm Etta Mae Mumphries.
Hi there.
Told us you were going to be here.
All right, then. Well, y'all know I'm old, so y'all talking about history, I want to get in on it. Who are we talking about today?
Well, this week is very timely. Mm-hmm. It's how Sissy Houston and Dionne Warwick shaped Whitney Houston.
Oh, yes, yes. Beautiful ladies and all three friends of mine.
Shocking.
Yeah, oh, you know that Dionne Warwick. She wrote that song she was singing, Do You Know the Way the Friends Know?
What? I don't remember.
No, I know. Don't sound right at all, do
no,
it?
No.
I told her, honey, keep on going up that freeway, all the way up to 5. Don't stop till you get to San Jose. Do you know the way to San Jose? She wrote that song. She never looked back, and the rest is history. Black history.
Hmm. I didn't know your Model T Ford could make it all the way to San Jose.
Yeah,
that was quite interesting, Etta Mae.
Thank you, son. And oh, you know, Sissy, when she had that beautiful baby Whitney, I took one look at that child. I knew she could sing like an angel. And I said, Sissy, Whitney needs a really good God-fearing godmother. So why don't you call up Riri?
Riri? Rihanna? Riri?
Oh, no, honey. You know, I'm talking about the Riri. You know, Aretha. Aretha Franklin.
The real Riri.
Yeah, say that three times.
The real, I can't.
Well, but Aretha, you know, I said Aretha can teach you some of that good church singing, you know, and teach you how to get some R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
Yes, fifth grade spelling bee champion.
Look at you.
We do know how to spell.
You do know. Well, we got the spelling down. Now let's get on with the mathematics.
It's BLAQmatics.
BLAQmatics. What did I say?
Something else.
Oh, okay. You know, sometimes my teeth, you know, they get loose and get away from me. Let me go get some Polident right quick. Y'all carry on.
What was that about?
I don't know, but I feel like I should call my grandmother now.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's this week's BLAQmatics.
Sissy Houston was an R&B singer in the 1970s who performed backup for Aretha Franklin, Otis Redding, and Jimi Hendrix. As a solo act, her success never reached the pinnacle. However, in the 1990s, her musical focus changed to gospel, where it flourished. Sissy won her first Grammy Award in 1996 and another just 2 years later, both from the gospel genre she is now most famous for. A bit of Sissy Houston trivia, she performed the original song, Midnight Train to Georgia, but it didn't become a hit until Gladys Knight and the Pips covered it. While Sissy Houston's career took a while to gain footing, her niece, Dionne Warwick, shot up like a rocket. She was singing backup when she was introduced to legendary songwriter Burt Bacharach, and she became his muse. Warwick's chart-topping hits include Walk On By, I'll Never Love This Way Again, I Say a Little Prayer, and That's What Friends Are For. Warwick has amassed 6 Grammy Awards and has had other artists like Luther Vandross and Aretha Franklin do renditions of her songs. With Sissy's rise through the gospel market and Dionne more than holding her own in the pop world, it's obvious the family is talented. But no one could have foreseen the meteoric rise reached by Sissy's daughter, Whitney Elizabeth Houston. Miss Houston is recognized by the Guinness Book of World Records as the most awarded female act of all time. She has sold over 170 million records worldwide. She has 2 Emmy Awards, 6 Grammys, 22 American Music Awards, and 30 Billboard Music Awards. Of her 10 released albums, none of them have reached less than gold, and 3 of them have attained diamond status. True to her roots, Whitney has crossed into the gospel world, starring in and performing songs for the film The Preacher's Wife, and performing duets with established gospel singers such as Kim Burrell and CeCe Winans. Although her own songs were revered by audiences worldwide, her most iconic songs are covers. Dolly Parton's I Will Always Love You is the 2nd best-selling single of all time by a female artist, with 12 million copies sold. The other is the Star-Spangled Banner, which she performed at the Super Bowl in 1991. Is the only rendition to be certified platinum. Although she has gone too soon, her music and legacy will live and last forever.
That was very nice and well done.
It was indeed. I was a huge fan of Whitney Houston.
Me too.
She will be missed. Well, Abba Arthur is here for our extended outlook. Abba?
Good morning, everyone. Let's put up that reminder for today's high chance of praise going on at Greater Zion today with Bishop Ulmer helping us celebrate Pastor Michael Fisher's anniversary. That kicks off today at 5 p.m. This Wednesday's midweek service will be led by Pastor Sheridan McDaniel at 7 p.m. in the living room. Also in the living room this Thursday at 7 p.m. will be Men's Discipleship. And Frontline will be continuing its series this Friday at 7:30 p.m. in the Trinity Building. This week we'll be discussing the law of attraction. Hello. All right, hopefully we'll see you guys there. Back to you.
Well, that's it for this week. If you enjoyed me, my name is Kente Scott. If not, my name is Johnny Mountain.
And I'm Kimberly Dooley. From all of us here at FCBCtv News, thanks for watching and happy President's Day.
Whew, glad I made it through. Help me out.
What?
Oh, really? Leave me hanging.
Just kidding.
It's too late.